Hello students, how are you all? Today I'm going to discuss Grand Test 3. So let us start with the first bit. Yes, first one. An organic compound on analysis was found to contain 10.06% of carbon, 0.8% of hydrogen, and 89.10% of chlorine. Then what is the empirical formula of a substance? You know that. So carbon, next one hydrogen, next one chlorine. Carbon given is 10.06 and 0.84. It is 89.10. So this will be divided with which one? Its mass divided with mass divided with molecular mass. That is 35.5. On solving, you will get 0.8384 and it becomes 2.4 gram. Then divide with a small value 84 by 83 and 2.4 by 0.3. So one time it is 3 times. CHCl3, simply taken as CHCl3. Option B correct, second option. Next. Yeah, if helium atom and hydrogen molecule are moving with the same velocity, their wavelength ratio will be. Wavelength ratio. Wavelength velocity relation we know, that is de Broglie's relation. So lambda equal to h by m. We want the relation between the wavelength and which one? Velocity. Mass given already. So they are asking their wavelengths. Lambda 1 by lambda 2 equal to. So m2 by m. Clear? Lambda 1 is helium, lambda 2 is hydrogen, it is hydrogen, it is helium. Solve it. Hydrogen 2 grams by mass of helium 4 grams. So what is the ratio you will get? 1:2. Answer will be B, second option. Next. Which of the following reactions leads to the discovery of neutrons? Neutrons are discovered by, you have to verify, you know, in your physics. So 4 plus 2, 6. 9 plus 3, 12. One left, that is neutron. So I think the right option is which one? Second option. Next. Ionization potential value of sodium is how much? 5.48. So the ionization potential of potassium is sodium, smaller size, potassium, larger size. Size increases, ionization potential values will be decreases. It means the value of ionization enthalpy of potassium is less than that of sodium because of its size. So less means 4.8, not same, not 5.68, not 10.8. The value must be less than that of sodium, right? Next. When O2 is converted into O2 plus, both the paramagnetic character and bond order will be increased. You have to find that. So now bond order is equal to, so half into number of bonding electrons minus number of anti-bonding electrons. In oxygen molecule, bond order will be, you have to write the electronic configuration sigma 1s2, sigma star 1s2, sigma 2s2, sigma star 2s2, right? Sigma 2px, phi 2px, phi 2py, phi star 2px, phi star 2py, sigma star 2px, right? So bonding electrons totally 10 and anti-bonding electrons 6, that is equal to 2 bond order. It is bond order for oxygen molecule. Right now, next, bond order for O2 plus means one electron decreased. So bond order equal to half into bonding electrons 10 only, verify electronic configuration, and anti-bonding electrons will be +1 means one electron decreased, then that is equal to 5/10, 2.5. Bond order in O2 to O2 plus will be 2.5. Clear? Bond order increases. Here unpaired electrons equal to 2. Here unpaired electrons equal to 1. Clear? Unpaired electron decreases less paramagnetic. And it is more paramagnetic. Less bond order, more bond order. Now you check the paramagnetic character from O2 to O2 plus will be decreased. And bond order will be, what happened here, increased. Right option D. You have to write the electronic configuration, then you can understand it. Next. The CCl bond is stronger than Ci bond because the CCl bond is more ionic than Ci bond. Ionic nature, size of anion increases, polarization increases, covalent character increases. Clear? Size decreases, covalent character decreases, and ionic character increases. Ionic character increases, bond will be strong. Clear? Now, chlorine is small size, that's why ionic character increases strong. Because of smaller size of chloride ion, it is ionic, that's why strong. So, CCl bond is ionic than Ci bond. Next. So a curve drawn at a constant pressure is called isobar and shows a relationship between. At a constant pressure, there is a graph drawn between the temperature and volume. This is for Charles' law. Volume is directly proportional to temperature. Now already seen, it is a Charles' law. At a constant pressure, the curves obtained are called isobars. Option C correct. Next, the heat required to raise the temperature of a body by 1 Kelvin is called heat capacity or thermal capacity. By 1 degree Celsius is called specific heat. Definition. Next, enthalpy of solution of NaOH in water is -41 kilojoules. When NaOH is dissolved in water, the temperature of water will change. Enthalpy of solution means when you added a solute to the solvent during the dissolution, something amount of heat is absorbed or released. That is called enthalpy change. Similarly, here also. Enthalpy of dissolution of NaOH in water is -41.6. It means dissolution of NaOH in water is exothermic. Exothermic means heat will be released. Heat released. Obviously, the temperature of water will be increased. In the beginning, NaOH and water, there is no heat. While dissolving heat released, then obviously the water gets heated, temperature increases. So, then answer will be option A, because dissolution is exothermic. Next. The solubility of Ca3PO4 twice is which one? Y moles per liter. What is the solubility product? Ca3PO4 twice given as to 3Ca plus 2 plus 2PO4 minus 2 minus 3 is. Okay. This solubility taken as actually solubility indicated as Y in the question. Actually, we can indicate it as yes, but as per the question, why? It is 2 times 2y. It is 1, 3 times 3y. Solubility product is equal to. So, concentration of cation, its coefficient raised to power, into concentration of anion, its coefficient raised to power. Clear? Then, Ca plus 2. How much it is 3y whole cube into 2y, how much it is square cube, 3 is 9 is 27, y into y cube, and 2 is 4y into y square, 4y square, that is equal to 108, y to the power of 5 answer. So that is option B correct. Okay. Next, a buffer solution can be prepared by the following mixtures. So, by which one you can easily prepare? Sodium acetate and acetic acid. Buffer solution is acidic and basic. Acidic is from weak acid and it's a salt with a strong base. And basic buffer is a weak base and it's salt with strong acid. Similarly here also, sodium acetate and acetic acid. CH3COONa plus CH3COOH. It is weak acid and it's salt with a strong base. That's why yes, it is buffer. Second, sodium acetate and hydro CH3COONa plus hydrochloric acid HCl. On reaction, then give rise to CH3COOH plus NaCl. Students, you observe clearly, in the mixture, reaction mixture, we have sodium acetate and acetic acid. Based on their concentration, we can say it is a limiting reagent, clear? Then, it must be a limiting reagent, it is an excess reagent. Right now, then. Sodium acetate and acetic acid, weak acid and its salt with the strongness, then this mixture also acting as acidic buffer. Similar, ammonium hydroxide and ammonium chloride, ammonium hydroxide and ammonium chloride, clear? Here, weak base and its salt with the strong acid hydrogen chloride, then it is also acting as one buffer. Now the right option is all the above. Here by mistake N type, you just remove that. Next, oxidation state of chromium in the following structure is yes, CrO is double bond. This is minus 2. 1, 2, 3, 4. These oxygens are peroxy oxygens. So, 1, 2, 3, 4 oxygens are peroxy. It is a normal oxygen. For normal oxy, minus 2. For peroxy, minus 1. So, finally, chromium plus 1 normal oxygen plus 4 peroxy oxygens. No charge. That's why equal to 0. Chromium we don't know else. It is a normal oxygen. For that minus 2 plus. It is a peroxy oxygen. For that 4 into minus 1. It is equal to 0. Then x minus 2 minus 4 equals to 0. X equal to plus 6. Very, very important for objective purpose. So the option is B, second. Next, hydrogen does not combine with helium. Hydrogen does not combine with helium. Yes, hydrogen does not combine with which elements? Helium, bismuth, sodium, and argon. These three are 15th group elements. Yes, possible. There is hydride formation, but helium is a noble gas. It will not. So that's why option A correct. Next. Which of the following statements are correct for alkali metal compounds? Alkali metal compounds. First option. Superoxides are paramagnetic in nature. Superoxide means O2 minus 1. Superoxide. Two oxygens are there, 2x equal to. The charge is minus 1. If no charge, must be equal to 0. Then x equal to minus 1 by 2. Oxygen bond order already we calculated, that is equal to 2. Okay. Next, O2 minus 1 bond order will be half into 10 bonding electrons. One more extra, that is, so that is 7. So now half into 3, that is equal to 1.5. Okay. So now 1 unpaired electron is possible. 1 unpaired electron is possible. Superoxides are paramagnetic due to 1 unpaired electron. Next, correct. The basic strength of hydroxides increases down the top to bottom alkali metal hydroxides are more basic because they can easily give OH minus ions because the bond length is more from top to bottom. Clear it is? So that's why it is also true. The conductivity of chlorides in their aqueous solutions decreases down the group because the reason is right. Next, the conductivity of chlorides in their aqueous solution, you need to underline the word aqueous solution, decreases down the group. It is a very, very important conductivity. For example, lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, last one is Cc. Size is smaller, gradually increases. Last one will be the larger one. Right? Now, when you added water, so it undergoes more hydration. More hydration means because of the smaller water molecules are attracted more, obviously OH2, it is H2O. Smaller one, H2O, H2O, H2O. Then more number of water molecules surround. It is larger, the distance is very high. Very few water molecules will be surrounded solution, then obviously size will be less. It is large, it is small. It is after which one, that is solution in water. When you added water to the alkali metals, what will be happen is solution or hydration taking place. Obviously, the smaller one becomes large, the larger one becomes small. So after solvation, the size of cesium is small. Small one can easily move from one place to another place. Hence, migration more, conductivity also more. It means after solvation, top to bottom, the size of ion decreases after solvation. Migration will be increases, conductivity also increases. But here they gave decreases. That's why it is a wrong statement. Next, the basic nature of carbonates in aqueous solution is due to which hydrolysis given? Cationic hydrolysis. But it is not cationic hydrolysis. It is by anionic hydrolysis. Option 1 and 2 correct. The right answer is verify. The right answer option 1 and 2 only correct. Second option. Next. Which a given anion, the correct stability order of tetrahaloborates. The stability is the first option because the reason is chlorine is smaller than bromine and iron. If size decreases, overlapping will be stronger. Size increases, overlapping will be small. So, size decreases, overlapping of orbitals will be increased. Orbitals increases, then strength will be and stability will be increases. Then answer will be option A. That is next. Red color complex is formed on adding FeCl3 to sodium extract. Then the compound formed by the presence of nitrogen and sulfur is FeCl3 will be written as Fe+3 plus SCN minus, then give rest to Fe SCN. So it will be +2. Fe SCN +2. So the given option among them which is correct, that is Fe SCN or MCS, whatever, CMS +2. It is correct. Can be written as FeCMS. Actually, it is right. They didn't give. The relevant is option B. Next. Hexaozonosis gives diol. Why reacts with base reagent gives diol? What are hexane? Diol means CHOCHO. It is diol. So to get this CH triple bond CHO3ZnH2O required. The formula will be C2H2. Yes, it is X. Okay. Next. With the base reagent, diol is obtained. Cold dilute alkaline KMnO4 is called Bayer's reagent. So to this, alkenes can give dipoles with Bayer's reagent. Then the formula will be C2H4. It is Y. C2H2 and C2H4. Option C correct. Next. Which of the following has minimum boiling point? So branched carbon hydrocarbons having a smaller size and less boiling point. So chain is large size, more boiling point. Isobutene is the branched one. One butane chain, N-butane also chain. Iso means a chain one. So that's why. So it is having a minimum boiling point. Next. The reaction of propene with HOCl via the addition of propene CH3CH double bond CH2 plus HOCl. Here it is OH minus Cl plus. In the beginning, this will be shifted here. So Cl plus will be added. So Cl plus means it is minus, it is a plus. CH3 CH plus CH2 Cl. Afterwards, this is treated with OH minus, gives rise to CH3 CH OH and CH2 Cl. So this is formed. And it is electrophilic addition reaction. First, Cl plus will be added, followed by OH minus. That's why the right answer is Cl plus in the first step. It is electrophilic addition. Next. Bit number 2. Three samples of water ABCD have demand oxygen values given 1, 3, 5, 8 milligrams per liter. The more polluted sample of water is, which is the more sample? DO means the amount of oxygen dissolved in water. Demand oxygen. It means the amount of oxygen present in water for aquatic life. Aquatic life means so trees means which is located in the water, fish, whatever. Now, amount of oxygen dissolved in water. First sample only 1 milligram. Last sample 8. In which case more amount of oxygen? D sample. Oxygen more, aquatic life is more possible. Oxygen less, aquatic life is less possible. That indicates more polluted. Less oxygen present in water, the water is more polluted. More oxygen present in water, the water is less polluted. Demand oxygen value or dissolved oxygen value decreases, pollution of water will be increased. Answer will be lower the DO value, more is the pollution in water. More polluted water only they are extracting. Option A. Next, in a cubic structure of diamond which made of X and Y, X atoms are at corners, Y atoms are at face centers. What is the formula? X at the corners, Y at face centers. Right? So corner contribution is 1/8. How many corners? Totally 8. One face contribution is 1/2 per one unit cell, totally 6 faces. That is equal to 1, 3. X, Y, 3 is the right answer. So option D correct. Next, copper crystallizes in FCC unit cell. The edge length given is 361 picometers. What is the radius of the copper? FCC unit. You know the formula. 4R equal to root 2A for FCC. We need which one? Radius equal to root 2A by 4. Root 2 means 1.414 into. Edge length is 361 picometers by 4. On solving you get answer 128 picometers. Next. What is the structure of NaCl? The structure of NaCl is FCC, face centered cubic. It means sodium ions located at edge center and body center, and chloride ions located at corners and face center. Finally, it is considered as FCC unit cell. Next, the freezing point depression constant KF value here 1.86. 45 grams of ethylene glycol is mixed with 600 grams of water. Then freezing point of solutions. Freezing point of solution is indicated as TF is equal to how much? Delta TF equal to, what is the formula? I into KF into molality, small m. So here I value will be 1. Ethylene glycol is a non-volatile solute. I will be only 1 into KF value 1.86. Molality means mass by gram molecular mass into 1000 by volume of solvent in grams. This is the formula. Then 1 into 1.86 into mass given is 45 by ethylene glycol CH2OH and CH2OH. 2 12 is 24, 4 hydrogens plus 4 28, 2 16 is 32, right? Totally, so you get the value that is equal to 50 into 1000 by volume of solvent equal to how much? 600 grams. On solving this, you will get the value will 2.68. This is the delta T. Delta TF equal to TF naught minus TF. It is for solution, it is for pure solvent. Correct? Pure solvent, okay. TF equal to TF naught minus delta TF. Right? TF naught, pure solvent, pure water. Freezing point will be 0 degrees Celsius, otherwise 273 kelvins minus this will be 2.68. On solving, you'll get the answer, that is 270.95, which one? The kelvins answer will be. So 24th option B correct. Next. Which of the following concentration factors affected by the change in temperature? Which is the temperature dependent, which is independent? That is what they are asking. Molarity. Number of moles of solute present in 1 liter of a solution called which one? Molarity. Volume, that's why dependent. Here solvent in grams, weight dependent. Mole fraction also, it is a mole fraction. Weight fraction also. These are all independent, molarity only dependent. Next. How many moles of Al2SO4 thrice would be present in 50 grams? Number of moles equal to mass by molar mass. Mass by molar mass. Where mass equal to 50, for Al2SO4 thrice, aluminium, so 27, 2 into 27. Sulfur 32, 3 sulfurs, 3 into 32. Oxygen 16, 4 into 3, 12 oxygens are there, 12 into 16. Add all those, then you get 342. On solving, so you get the answer 0.140 moles. Next. Four alkali metals A, B, C, D given, their electrode potentials also given. And which one will be the most reactive? Reactivity depends on oxidation. For oxidation, SRP values will be, value is more negative. Very less value for oxidation. Clear? Then you can easily understand. So more negative, minus 3.05, option A. More is the negative, obviously more is the oxidation. Oxidation more means reactivity also more. Option A correct. Next. The specific conductance of 0.1 normal KCl solution at 23 degrees Celsius given. 0.12, the which one given, the resistance given is 55 ohms, and what is the cell constant? Cell constant is indicated as G star equal to R into K. R equal to resistance, K equal to specific conductance. Resistance how much given? 55. Specific conductance given is 0.012, that's it. Right, with units also you can, 55 ohms into 0.012 ohm inverse centimeter. Inverse ohm cancel. On solving you get the answer will be 0.66 centimeter inverse. That is G star. G star equal to cell constant. Next. The cell constant formula is G star formula they are asked. That is length by area of cross section. The length between the two parallel electrodes and the area of cross section of an electrode, if the ratio is taken as which one? L by A. L by A is G star. 1 by A square versus time are straight line in which order? So you should know first of all, zero order rate constant, first order, second order, third order. I'll verify the right one. So that is KT equal to, so 1 by 2 into 1 by A square minus 1 by A naught square. Yes. This is for third order I have. Better you remember all these rate equations, integrated rate equations, to draw graphs, logical questions are possible. It is a third order. So now, for our convenience, I am taking 1 by A and time. This is time, it is 1 by A. Graph we are expecting. Obviously, both are directly, time is equal to 1 by 2k into 1 by A square minus 1 by A naught square. Final concentration, it is initial concentration. So you can take like this, y equal to mx plus c. Right now, so finally, draw the graph 1 by A square. So 1 by A square. So it is time. Obviously, directly or inversely, it is directly. Slope is positive and intercept is minus. Intercept is 1 by A naught square. So, direct straight line is obtained for which one? Second order or third order? It is third. Verify for second order also like this. Next. The reaction SO2 plus O2 gives rise to SO3 carried out in 1 liter vessel as well as 2 liters vessel. The ratio of the reaction velocities will be. So now velocities rate equal to 2SO2 plus O2 gives rise to 2SO3. Yes. Rate is equal to R1K into SO2 square O2 power 1. So clear, it is concentration. Concentration means moles per volume. Mole per volume means moles, they didn't give per volume means 1 liter. By volume 1, you will get the same value. Next, R2 equal. This is taking place in 1 liter vessel. Okay? In 1 liter vessel. R2 equal in 2 liters vessel. Consider. So K moles of SO2 by volume will be how much? 2 liters. Mole square. Moles of O2 by and volume will be 2 liters, it is 1. Then you will get. So consider 1 by 2. This is taken as 1, this is taken as 2, 1 by 2. It is also taken as R1 by R2 ratio they are expecting. So what is cancelled? This one will be cancelled right now. And what is left here? 1 left, 1 by 1 by 2 into 1 by 2, 1 by 4, 1 by 4 into 1 by 2, 1 by 8. Then you will get 8 is to 1 answer. Answer D. Next. The plot between the concentration versus time for zero order reaction represented by concentration versus time. In any order reaction, concentration of reactant will be decreases with the time. Because during the reaction, concentration of reactants must be decreased. So answer will be D, option B correct. So otherwise you can find with equation also A equal to A naught minus K. It is concentration, it is time. So obviously Y equal to Mx plus C. So slope is negative. You draw the graph, A it is, and it is time, obviously like this. Slope is minus k, intercept is, what is that? A naught. It is for which order reaction? Zero order reaction, as you know that. Okay.